Welcome to the Executive Innovation Show podcast, where we bring you real executive conversations with industry game changers and thought leaders. We ask the questions you're thinking, what you're scared to ask, and we make your brain hurt afterward. With your host, Carrie Chitsy Wells, co-founder and CEO of One Touch Video Chat, live video interviews, and the nonprofit Humans Helping Humans.
Thanks, everybody, for joining, and welcome to today's Knowledge Knugget. We're going to be talking about telepharmacy and telegenetics, which are both hot topics. Today's Knowledge Nugget guest is Dr. Richard Harris. He is both a physician as well as a pharmacist, so he brings the best industry knowledge we have today on both topics and how the role of the physician and the pharmacist can work together. We've asked him three questions today that he's going to answer. We're going to be talking about how you can extend telepharmacy into the home. What's the future role of the pharmacist, and how can we really help out a lot of areas on prescription adherence, why that's so important, and what other roles can the pharmacist play using telepharmacy to help with disease management, education, and other things that is big need in chronic care conditions today. We're also going to be talking about how can the pharmacist really help with telepharmacy as well as other things to really help about diet and nutrition, especially with your diabetes patients, your renal patients, and things of that nature. How can they help with that, and why are they skilled to help with that? He gives some great insights being both a physician and a pharmacist. He can kind of put on both hats and tell you who is the better role for that. And then the last one, we're going to talk about the genetics testing. A lot of people are getting genetics testing, taking it to their physician, and they don't really know what to do with it. So is telegenetics best staffed by physicians or by pharmacists? You might be interested to hear, wearing both roles, where he thinks telegenetics should be handled with the patient, and how supplements and things of that nature can really help out if looking at those results correctly. So let's talk to Dr. Richard Harris, hear what he has to say. He is our expert today for the Knowledge Nugget. Dr. Harris?
Hello, my name is Dr. Richard Harris, and I'm the founder of Great Health and Wellness, a personalized medicine company in Houston, Texas. I'm a physician and a pharmacist, and for today's Knowledge Nugget, we're gonna be talking about three for three, three subjects and 3 points about each subject. So the first question is, what role can pharmacists play in patient supplements and diet? I think the pharmacist can play an extremely large role in this area, and it will allow them to practice at the top of their license. They can make proper supplement recommendations for certain disease states. They can also check for interactions with medications. The second point is huge because supplements do have a role, but they can't interact with certain medications. And so the pharmacists are uniquely qualified to make these checks for interactions with medications. And they can also make recommendations for nutrition plans based upon certain conditions. You know, certain medical conditions respond a little bit better to certain nutrition plans. And this is an area where the pharmacist can intervene and make direct recommendations to patients. The second question is, how can pharmacists extend the services to the home with telepharmacy? So a big way the pharmacist can extend services to home with telepharmacy is adherence to medications and side effects. We know that in the real world, there's about a 50 to 60% medication adherence rate, but we estimate that in order to be successful, therapy needs to be around 80% adherent. So pharmacists, by doing checkups in the home through the telepharmacy, could ensure adherence rates and better optimization and outcomes to therapy. They can also reinforce disease education and treatment plans. You know, a lot of times people don't know what they're on or why they're taking it even. So pharmacists could reinforce education, reinforce why a person is taking a medication, and do health coaching where they're walking people through other things associated with that disease state. And they can also provide direct patient care through telepharmacy. This could be something as simple as a triage function, whether they need to be seen by a provider or go to the emergency room or something like that. Or again, letting pharmacists practice at the top of their license, treating things like hypertension, hyperlipidemia, uncomplicated diabetes. And so you're offloading some pressure on primary care providers in the clinic by having pharmacists do this where people are most comfortable at the home. Third question is, whose role is it to help patients better understand genetic testing and patient outcomes? Now, I know as an internal medicine physician, a lot of my colleagues are not very interested in this subject at all, which is a shame because genetic testing and nutrigenomic testing can really be a game changer for someone's chronic conditions or for preventative states. So I think that pharmacists can take a very proactive role in this area and offer these services in the clinic and be taught how to provide high quality information about nutrigenomics and genetic testing, and then at the same time recommend high quality GMP supplements. I think pharmacists have a better understanding of general physiology, and I say that because as a pharmacist and a physician going through both trainings, I know I got more physiology training in pharmacy school than I did in medical school, so I had a much greater understanding of physiology. And of course, having access to those high quality supplements, those GMP supplements, supplements that we know we can trust for potency and accuracy. So that has been today's Knowledge Nugget with Dr. Richard Harris. I hope you found the information informative and helpful. You can find me on Instagram and Twitter at drharrismd, that's Dr. Harris MD, or my podcast, the Strive for Great Health podcast. Thank you.
This podcast has come to a close. To hear more from the Executive Innovation Show podcast, subscribe, submit questions, and share the love. Follow us on social. We're everywhere.